So what are some of the biggest challenges you see when it comes to content marketing, especially when you're looking at, let's look at the smaller organizations, but also the big organizations? What is the biggest barrier to success when you're really looking at content marketing?
You know, I think the biggest barrier, besides the fact that a lot of financial brands that we work with don't have a really well-defined content marketing strategy as part of a larger digital growth strategy, it's the fact that most financial brands are telling the exact same story with their content. Coming back to that idea of, we have these great rates, we have these amazing services, these look-alike laundry lists of product features, and now post-COVID, it's the we're here for you. And I know that you've experienced that as well with some of the communication that you received. But what the problem is with this, and even financial brands who are dabbling with content, they might be purchasing content from a service. But the problem is that's the same exact content that another financial brand has. And so all of this is rooted in what I call narcissistic marketing. Think broadcast marketing. And when we think about narcissistic marketing, it really positions the financial brand as the hero in the stories that they tell. But if we go back and we study literature going all the way back to the cave paintings in the early days of man, there can only be one hero in a story. And for a consumer, that hero is themselves. That hero is the consumer. And when we position ourselves in our communication as a financial brand, as the hero, what we're doing is we're actually positioning ourselves as the anti-hero.
So really what you're talking about there is, we always talk about this customer-centric marketing and how important that is. But really what you're saying is, we don't want to anymore look and say, oh, we're going to use this to sell something. What we really want is the ability to talk to the consumer in their language and what they need. I mean, especially now with COVID, there's a lot of challenges going on. You know, consumers really have no idea. Okay, so I stopped my mortgage payment for a number of months. Okay, and I realized maybe I didn't need to. What do I do now? Do I catch up? Do I keep on, you know, putting money in savings? So really what you're talking about here, you're really looking at saying, you know, you got to flip the coin. You got to look at what is in for the consumer and really put them in the center on the real sense, as opposed to just saying it. Is that true?
Absolutely. And I love what you said. We need to talk to them in their language. You know, a lot of times we have the curse of knowledge as financial brands, whether you're on the marketing team or the sales team or the leadership team. So we know banker knees. We know what LTV and DTI means. But when you're talking and you're using all of this banker knees, it increases the confusion and the complexity, which is inherent in financial services. And so the best way to put people at the center of all of your thinking, all of your doing, all of your communication is to really begin to think about them as the heroes in this archetype journey. And we position our financial brand as the helpful guide, the Obi-Wan Kenobi, the Mr. Miyagi, the Yoda. And we're guiding these people on this journey. But just like if you think back to any major narrative, it took some time for the hero to begin to trust the guide. Luke didn't come out of the gate trusting Obi-Wan in Star Wars. Obi-Wan had to prove himself. And in this digital world, we prove ourselves through content. Content is built. Content builds trust. Content is like placing micro deposits in the trust bank for a consumer, which the trust bank is what's the trust fund is what sits between their ears. It's their brains. And it can take weeks, months, even years to make enough deposits to increase that consumer's courage to make the commitment to apply with your financial brand. It can take seconds to deplete all of that by getting the wrong message to that consumer at the wrong time. And it totally makes the whole experience fall apart.
Okay, so James Albert, let's dig a little bit deeper in that hero's journey. You know, you talk about it, and we talk about data and analytics and trying to make it on a personalized basis and understand the consumer. You know, when you look at this, when you look at journey maps, when you look at customer journeys and the hero's journey and everything else, you really are having to personalize it. How does an organization look at content as opposed to being a real broad brush? How do they make it a little bit narrower brush so that I feel like the consumer is talking to me, or so the bank financial institution is talking to me, or do we simply create more content so the consumer can select what's important to them?
Yeah, that's a great question. I think first and foremost, we need to just address the fact that there's such a tremendous gap in the ideas and the methodologies for mapping and defining digital journeys. From our studies, we found that around 85% of financial brands have not mapped these journeys out. And that creates a gap. And I think a lot of it is rooted in the fact that we have this legacy thinking from the old world of, we got broadcast marketing driving traffic into a branch. But when we look at, to back to your question of, do we need more content or do we need the right content? Well, I would say it's a mix of both. And when we look at the idea of digital consumer journeys and content, we can go and pick off our big product lines that we need to focus our content production around first and foremost. And the way that I would prioritize this is through those different stages of the buying journey. We need specific content for the awareness stage. We need content for the consideration stage. We need content for the purchase stage. And then that's just part half of the story, because we also need content for the onboarding stage. But then another opportunity is content for the advocacy stage. And so then it's not just those different stages. It's those different stages within the top 3 to 5 business lines of a financial brand. And that can feel like a very daunting and overwhelming task. And so the best way to approach this is to break things up and to prioritize not only the content production, but also, just as important, the content promotion. Because a financial brand can produce content and produce more content, but if they don't have the systems and processes to connect that content with the people, then it's not going to create any value whatsoever.